just want to introduce myself. My name's Pete, best man. And I want to re-thank the two people that brought us together tonight, bartenders. Just kidding. Mr. and Mrs. Lindsay and Connor Rowan. Connor, you are very lucky. You leave here gaining a partner who is warm, loving, caring, and who radiates kindness wherever she goes.
Lindsay and Connor, I hope your marriage is filled with many games of dominoes, date nights at Telefaric.
Yes.
A dog or two.
Oh, hell yeah.
And Lindsay, you are very lucky too. You leave here having gained a beautiful dress and some flowers. Lindsay, look after Connor, and every now and then lend him back to us so we can play golf. And in closing, just like golf, both of you need to continue to practice loving each other every day. Both of you guys are in this together, and you can't make it without practice. And maybe you'll also fix your terrible slice. So let's raise a glass to Mr. and Mrs. Rowan.
I'm so grateful for both of you and all your friendship. Cheers to Rowan down the aisle.
Right when it's wrong, I've stayed here too long, but something brings me back to you. I swear we belong, I'm
you?
Still hanging on.
No, that's so you.
And a slit.
That's beautiful. Nice flowers.
I like your flowers.
Thank you. I only one.
Connor, I am so excited to marry the man who is forgiving, patient, and caring. I'm excited to marry the man who has made me a better person by teaching me to slow down in life, who sometimes knows me better than I know myself, and the man who is willing to do anything for the people he loves. I know with you that I will always be protected, cared for, and most importantly, loved. I promise to be there for you when times get tough, when you need extra cuddle time, and when you need someone to drive the golf cart for you. I cannot wait to see what the future holds for us. I hope it includes travel, laughter, our minis, and much more. But whatever happens, I am so excited to do it all with you. I love you so much for sweet and sour. I love you.
Lindsay, we are about to embark on our maiden flight as husband and wife. As we soar above, I see nothing but adventure with you. I will never land without you. I can't help but think that in 2011, if you or anyone else would have told me I'd have a love story of this magnitude, let alone with you, I would have told you or anyone else that those types of stories were not made for me. Yet here we are. We are making that story a reality. From the moment we rekindled our relationship, I knew we would eventually get here. Everything in me recognizes your heart as my home and your arms as my shelter. I never ever want that to change, only to grow. To me, your personality, character, emotion, and just about everything else you are is an untamed yet passionate wildfire burning hot and bright from within. Your fire is dependable warmth, motivation, and a signal of pride, perseverance, devotion, and reality to all around you. However, you have a stronger force powering you from within, your love. Your love is like water. It is shapeless, it is formless, but is also peaceful, yet infinitely powerful to all it touches. It suffocates all fears and worries. You literally cannot live without water, and I cannot live without you. Lindsay, I promise to you, your family, and your friends that I'll always hold your hand and protect your heart from the dark shadows and the sometimes deceivingly bright rainbows we all strive to chase. You are my lifelong confidant, co-pilot, tea partner, and above all else, my wife. I love you.
There's a fire burning in my heart. And now, by the power vested in me by the universallifechurch.org, it is my honor and delight to declare you married. You may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my privilege to present to you for the very first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Rowan.